Welcome to Python tutorial series. In the previous videos, we have discussed with Python introduction, then Python installation steps, and with the sample example. And in this video, I am going to cover with few of the language fundamentals of Python, like identifiers, keywords, then data types, and few of the utility functions. I am also going to discuss with the various flavors of Python and the different versions we are working with. And I'll be covering with one or two simple hands-on examples also. Guys, if you like this tutorial series, do like it, subscribe to my channel, and share to the people who might need this topic. Let's get started. So coming to the different flavors of Python, so we have the different versions for different platforms. We can work with the Python applications into Java platform, C Sharp, and then C, etc. So C Python is the standard flavor of the Python. It can be used to work with C language applications. And Zython, we have this is mainly for Java application development, which can run on JVM as well. And coming to Iron Python, it is a specially designed for C Sharp .NET platform. And we also have the PyPy Python edition. So this is mainly to improve the performance of your Python virtual machine by making use of JIT compiler. And we also have Ruby Python. This is for Ruby platforms, and especially for data processing in very large volumes of data. So we have a version called Anaconda Python. It is designed for handling large amounts of data. Coming to, we have the different versions of Python, like 1.0 was introduced into 1994, and 2 we have in October 2000, and Python 3 was introduced in December 2008. The current version we are working with will be like we have the version 3.8.5, but I have installed the version 3.8.2. we will be working the hands-on example with 3.8.2. and coming to the language fundamentals of Python, like every language is provided with the language fundamentals. Once you are comfortable with the language fundamentals, only you can start working with that particular language to start writing applications. So here, just like any other programming language, Python also contains the basics of language fundamentals, like identifier. We know, like to start with any application, we need to handle with various identifiers to store the data, and as well as for temporary calculations and to display the results. So what are the rules we need to follow with, and what kind of characters are allowed to frame a identifier into Python? Okay, so here you can see Python identifier can contain alphabets, either can be lowercase or uppercase. And just like any other programming language, underscore is allowed for identifier in Python as well. And identifier can contain digits, but it cannot start with a digit, and identifiers are case sensitive. And certain special characters are not allowed into Python to frame the identifiers. So few of the example identifiers are here provided. You can just observe what identifier syntax is allowed and what is not allowed. Let's say digits you can have in the middle or at the end of your identifier, but it cannot start with the beginning. And underscore is allowed at any place of your identifier, and we cannot use with the reserved words as an identifier. This is a blunder rule for any programming language. And coming to reserved words, as we know, a set of reserved words for every particular language is reserved for a specific purpose. We can't violate that particular purpose, so we cannot reuse a reserved word for an identifier place. So you cannot use it as your own programming element in your application. So reserved words are reserved for a particular purpose. We have to make use only for that purpose. So this is I think every programming person will be knowing the purpose of reserved words, and every programming language will be having with a predefined set of reserved words. So those reserved words we have to use for that specific purpose only. For example, if okay, and then you have a class, you have try, and you have a break, continue. All these words are reserved for a particular purpose. And coming to the built-in data types of Python. So for every programming language, we will be having with the primitive data types, built-in data types. So those data types we'll be using for our application for storing the values and performing any type of computations. Python supports 14 different built-in data types. You can just look into that. We will be making use of these built-in data types for our applications. And we will be also having with user-defined data types and derived data type that we will come across in our future sessions. And coming to when we start with a simple hands-on basic examples, we will be coming across a few utility functions. There are hundreds and thousands of utility functions we have. We will be coming, we'll be practicing with all the library functions in our future sessions. But at the beginning, we will be working with a few of the utility functions like type to check the type of the identifier you are working with, and to display the address of a particular element, you can make use of ID as a function. And print is a function you will be using to print the value of the element or to print a message on the console. Let's get practice with simple hands-on examples by making use of these utility functions. Let's start with the Python editor. So here just basically I'll be defining a variable with a with the number 10. Like I would like to know what data type it is. So simply you can make use of the utility function called type of a. So it will be showing you the data type of it. Okay, it is saying that it is of type int. Similarly, you wanted to know the address of that particular a, ID of a. Similarly, you wanted to print the value of a. Simply you can say print of a. So it will print the value of that particular a value. Let's do with a simple application where we will be doing sum of numbers and then we will be printing in a formatted way by using a format function. Okay. So I am going to define a number called n1 is 25 and I am defining another number as 35. And I would like to calculate sum equal to like I wanted to calculate int of n1 and int of n2. Simply if I print some value, I'll be getting the total of those two numbers. Now I would like to print those numbers in a more formatted way. So let's print in this format. The sum of the first number is 0 index and the second number is going to be the first index is the third index value is going to be sum of the numbers. And then I'll write a function called format because we are going to display the content in a formatted fashion. So we are going to make use of function called format. And now we need to provide the values for the index positions for 0, 1 and 2. So in the 0th index we are going to display with n1 and the first index we are going to display with n2. And in the second index means the third value we are going to print with the sum value. So this is how you can format the content as well. And in a similar fashion, let us also practice with a float data type. Let's say I'm going to use with a number called a floating point data. And then there is another floating point value I have stored with. Now I would like to calculate a difference. Let us say difference equal to float of n3 minus float of n2. We are just calculating the difference. Let us print with our difference. Alright. And next, let us take the values at runtime. So I am going to take a number called s1 equal to, I will be using with an input function to input the value of s1, and I will give a number called 89. And now s2 equal to, I am going to once again use input function to enter s2 value. Now I am giving the value for s2. Now I would like to calculate sum equal to, I would like to calculate sum of s1 and s2. Now we can print the value . So the value, whatever we input, we are going to store into S1 and S2, and we are able to print the sum. This is how we can make use of basic utility functions to input the value, to find the address of a given data element, and to find the data type of an element, and to print at the console. This is what is the basic utility functions we have into Python. And that's all for this particular video. And in the coming sessions, we will be practicing with many more language fundamentals with the Python examples, with the control structures and other programming constructs. Thank you.